And welcome to Word of Inspiration. My name is Dr. Bertha Sewa Ayi, and I present Word of Inspiration, a daily program that is designed to encourage you in your daily walk and to motivate you to be the best version of yourself. Today, I present a message I've entitled The Encounter Part 1. And in this short message, I want to explain to you the encounter that a man called Nicodemus had with Jesus. My text is taken from the book of John, chapter 3, verse 5, and over there Jesus said, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot see the kingdom of God." My hope is that by the end of this message, you will understand exactly what Jesus was trying to tell Nicodemus. You will understand what it means to be born again in a very practical way, not just in theory. First of all, I want to explain to you the concept of the Spirit. Imagine that you're going on a date to meet somebody that you've never seen. It might be a woman or a man, depending on which gender that you are. You're all excited because this person is supposed to be so-so and so, they're beautiful, they're handsome, etc. And then you meet and your eyes lock. You think you're looking at the person, but I want you to know the person you're looking at is just a shell. The real person, you don't even know, because the person on the inside is a spirit. What you're looking at is just the shell. The spirit lives inside the person's body. It is only after you start talking to this individual, they begin to tell you who they are, their life's experiences, before you can actually get to know them and know what stuff they're made of. Then you know their spirit. Let me also give another illustration. I used to live near an Applebee's restaurant, and anytime I passed by, there were many cars parked around in the evening. The aroma was filled with cooking steak and all sorts of food. And you will enter the restaurant, it's full of life. One day, they had moved out. The building was still there, but it looked lifeless. It was empty. No cars were parked out. What was happening was that the spirit of the restaurant had left. The people, the cooking, everything that made up the restaurant had left. The building was still there. It was still the building, but the spirit had gone. That is why when we're born, God gives us life, and then when we die, our spirit leaves. I hope you are understanding me. So let's talk about the encounter. This man was Nicodemus. The Bible says that he was a Pharisee and a ruler of the Jews. Let's just say one of your congressmen or a member of parliament where you live. This man decided to go on a date with Jesus. He went to find Jesus. Jesus didn't know he was coming to meet him. One day, he dressed up and went to find Jesus. The Bible says in John chapter 3, verse 2, that he came to Jesus by night and asked him, "Rabbi, no one can do the type of miracles that you do unless God be with him." Jesus answered and said unto him, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, that except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." That was in John chapter 3, verse 3. Now, I'm sure this caught Nicodemus by surprise. And so he asked Jesus, "What do you mean born again? Can a man enter into his mother's womb and be born again?" So Jesus said the same thing he said in verse 3. This time he said, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot see the kingdom of God." In other words, Jesus was trying to tell him, when I said being born again in verse 3, I meant being born of water and of the Spirit. And Jesus went on to explain that whatever is born of flesh is flesh, but whatsoever is born of the Spirit is spirit. This man still didn't get it, like most of us don't. So he asked Jesus again, "How can these things be?" So Jesus went on to explain to him that you've seen the wind, right? When it's blowing, you can see it's going in this direction or that direction. Can you actually see the wind? The man said, "No." He said, "Well, similarly, so is everybody that is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus in this encounter kept on pushing Jesus's button. So finally Jesus told him, "Okay, wait a minute. Are you a leader of the Jews and you don't know all these things? Do you remember that Moses had to lift up a rod in the wilderness for the children of Israel to look at? Similarly, the Son of Man has to be lifted up." Jesus was creating a very, very important analogy here. Here is what had happened in the Old Testament. As the people of Israel came out of Egypt, as they were in the wilderness, one day they began to complain and God got mad, so angry that God sent serpents, snakes, venomous snakes among their midst to bite them and let them die. And these snakes were so venomous that people died instantaneously. So they cried out to God, and God told Moses to make a rod, a copper rod, and put the image of a snake on it, that anybody who looked at that snake, if they got bitten, will live. That was something completely miraculous. Now, in modern medicine, if you got bitten by a snake, you need an anti-venom. But in the Old Testament, God told Moses all the people had to do was to look at the snake. That is a powerful analogy. Now, when they looked at the snake without touching the rod, without even coming extremely close, they got healed. Jesus was using this example to tell Nicodemus that all you need to do is to believe. He says, "He who believes in me shall not perish but have eternal life." It's like, Nicodemus, is this thing beating your mind? This whole thing about being born of the Spirit and of the water? Well, I just want to make it simple. He that believes on the Son of God has eternal life. If you believe in me, you have eternal life. And then in verse 16, he says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoso believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life." Friend, you have a spirit on the inside of you. Because of the first Adam, because Adam sinned, the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians 15 verse 45 that the first Adam became a living soul, but the second Adam became a quickening spirit. Jesus was sent into the world that we would become a living spirit. And that is why when he was born, angels appeared unto shepherds and said, "Behold, unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior. I bring you glad tidings of great joy." Jesus' birth was supposed to signify great joy to the whole world, because now men's spirits which were dead, corrupt, cannot be made alive again. People can become born again. This is what Jesus was talking about. Unfortunately, he continues to say that he has come as a light into the world, and people love darkness rather than light. But so long as we believe on him, he gives you the power to become the Son of God. Today, in a nutshell, I've tried to explain to you the encounter that a man called Nicodemus had with Jesus. He came to Jesus at night trying to find some things out, trying to see, "Jesus, what is the secret behind this thing?" Jesus made him know, "I'm operating in miracles because I'm in the kingdom of God." And I'm telling you, he told him twice, "Until you become born again, until you become born of water and of the Spirit, you cannot see the kingdom of God." Friend, one day we will all die. The Bible says it is appointed unto man once to die, and after that judgment. One day we'll all die and meet our Savior. Are you ready? Are you born again? The Bible says that the blood of Jesus makes us born again. In part two, I will talk about this, but today I want you to think about your own life. If you've never given your life to Christ, or you've looked at some people and say, "Oh, all these born again people," they're not some born again people. It is a transition. It is a translation, as I will talk about tomorrow. God wants you to give your life to Christ and be born of the water and of the Spirit. Let us pray. Father, we thank you so much for your word. We thank you that you sent Jesus Christ. The Bible says you loved us so much that you sent Jesus Christ into the world, that once we believe in him, we will have eternal life. We will not perish. And just as the Israelites looked at a serpent on a rod and got healed, we don't need any magic. It doesn't take any magic. It's just one thing: believing that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And as we believe in him, our spirits will be made anew. We thank you. This is what we ask with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. Today the Lord bless you and keep you. May he cause his countenance to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. This is what I ask in Jesus' name. Say this after me: I'm a winner. I'm more than a conqueror. I will live and I will not die. I will live to fulfill God's plan concerning my life. I'm the head and not the tail, above and never below, and I'm more than a conqueror, in Jesus' name. My name is Dr. Bertha Ayi. Please join me tomorrow. God richly bless you.